Hello guys, welcome back to Planet Hack Security. In this club video, we're going to be talking about box suit. So if you know what box suit means, I'll be explaining what box suit actually means in this particular slide. So box suit is a full Intel Linux which is pre-built. You can also download in your other versions of OS if you're using Windows, Parrot or something else. You can also download box suit. So if you don't know what box suit actually means, it's used by penetration testers, bug bounty hunters, or hackers in general for their daily hacking of web applications. Okay, so as you can see right here, we have box suit which is sitting in the middle of your browser and the website you are trying to hack. Okay, so your browser actually, hope you guys are seeing clearly, or I should make this a little bit zoomed. Okay, so you see your browser right here is actually sending a request to the website you are browsing. If you are browsing google.com, you see your browser has to be sending some kind of request to google.com. So what box suit actually do, it sits in the middle of your browser and the website you are browsing. So before this particular request will be going to the website, if you're browsing google.com right here, and you see that before it will get to this website, box suit will actually capture the request, and then you can be able to modify the kind of request. Like for example, if you have some kind of data you are sending to the website, you can maybe adjust or to edit data by sending some incorrect or some kind of data Google is not expecting. So maybe if you are like you are browsing on a website which you might be able to purchase some goods, box suit is actually a tool that you can be able to capture the request and change the prices, the amounts, and do some kind of malicious things. So this quick recap, this video is only for educational purposes only, so you guys should stay ethical and don't go hack a site you are not permitted to. So okay, so I have another slide here. You see we are also having some kind of the tools are going to be covering in particular course. So we're covering how to use the proxy, the scanner, the encoder, the repeater, and so on. So you guys see this is a typical box suit right here. So if you have box suit installed, we'll be teaching you how you can be able to do a lot of that. Okay, so I'm going to go to, you see my favorite here, I have box suit community edition, so I'm going to click on it so it will open for me very very quickly. So let's wait for it a little bit. If you don't know what box suit actually means, this course is actually for beginners, so I'll be explaining everything in depth. If you know what how to use box suit already, might be some good maybe some good results you'll be able to learn out right here. So there's no harm, there's nothing bad in you watching this particular video. So quickly like and subscribe to this video while we continue with the main course. Okay, so I have box suit 1.7.30 version, which is I think is 2.17 version. So I'll be showing you guys from this particular version because this is what I love to use for my daily hacking and my bug bounty huntings. Okay, so as you can see, we have all these options right here. I'll be explaining everything one by one, and we're going through the practical aspect of how we can actually start using this. So as you can see, this is the target. Once we start by hacking on the site, you see the target is going to display here the sites you are browsing. Like once we are browsing on your Firefox, on your Chrome, whatever site you are browsing with, and you see we are actually sitting in between your Firefox and the website you are browsing on. Okay, so before any request is going to your browser, it's going to the site, the client you are browsing on, it's box suit actually is going to capture this request in this particular site here. Okay, so if you come to this, which is your target, this is the target that you are browsing. So if you come to the sitemap, you will start seeing the list of the sites you have browsed, coming to this place, all the requests you have sent. You're going to see them in practical right here. So if you come to the scope, you'll be able to come and add, if you're hacking on, let's say www.hacking.com, you can come here and set it to hacking.com, so that whatever will be in your sitemap here will be only the hacking.com, because you don't want to start seeing other stuff you are not hacking on. So that's the scope for you. So we're going to cover it in practical. Okay, so this proxy right here is, you can see it's already set to the default of on, and you can set it to off. So once you're browsing the site, if you want to capture the time request, that particular request you are sending to, as you are clicking on the button on the browser, you are browsing, you can set this to on so you intercept the request immediately so that you can adjust it and send back to the browser. This is I'm going to cover this in practical. So you have the HTTP request under the proxy. Please and please, we started from targets to the proxy, and we are going to go into the spider and all that things right here. So under this proxy, we have the intercept that I showed you guys. The HTTP request also is a kind of request, this kind of tab where you see all the requests you have sent. So as you can see, it's some kind of history of all the buttons you have actually clicked in your browser. So it's going to show right here, and you see the WebSocket history and some options you can start to set. So I'm going to cover this in practical. I just want to give a quick explanation of all this before we go to the practical aspect. You see the spider right here. This spider right here is a kind of tool whereby if you actually capture the request, the browser site you are browsing, you can actually send it to spider. Spider will help you click on every buttons by itself automatically, so you start seeing all the buttons in your proxy. Okay, so once you are actually spidering a site, like you're automatically clicking on that site using WebSuite, but you're not clicking on it on your browser. Through by using WebSuite, you're actually clicking on the site. So if you come to the spider, you are going to see all the amount of requests you are sending right here, while all the requests will be going to your history. Okay, so you have some kind of scanners here, and it's actually for people who have purchased the professional edition. This is the community edition, which is free for everyone to use. So if you come here, you can start seeing how you can be able to set active scan so that you start finding your abilities using professional edition. So in this video, we are going to be using community edition because people who are getting into hacking newly won't be able to pay for the professional edition. So we are going to learn how we can find these bugs one after the other manually, because we don't actually have community professional edition. Okay, so we have the intruder right here, this which is the next tab here. So this intruder right here is a kind of tool that is used to send requests to the browser automatically, most especially brute force attack. If you have heard of brute force attack, you can use it to perform username and password brute force, directory brute force, API brute force, and other things. So you can come here and start setting the paths and others. So we are going to be covering all this in practical. So this video is going to be very, very informational for you guys. If you haven't liked the video, please do. So we have the repeater here. This repeater is actually capturing the request you actually send. Once you send a request to the repeater, you can start resending each request. If you want to send a particular request 1 time, 2 times, 3 times, 4 times by adjusting the data you are having, you can start doing that right here. So some kind of repeats for you to have the request and start repeating them by sending them to the clients you're hacking on. So we have the sequencer here. So in this sequencer, as you can see, it's going to also capture requests and some kind of starts live capturing. So if you are using the sequencer, you are going to be, for example, you have some kind of live capturing for you to be getting the request you are sending. So you have to do some kind of manual checks and this and other things in the sequencer. Why this decoder is some kind of, for example, you're having some kind of digits, you can come here and say you want to decode it to maybe HTML, URL, or some kind of binary. So because most times some websites you are browsing, they're actually using some kind of encoding to encode the data in the URL parameters or the web pages. So this decoder helps you to decode most of those stuff, all right? So if you come to the compare, for example, you have some kind of token, you can come here and say, okay, let me start comparing to know the differences between this token and this token. So as the name has said, it's nothing more than how to compare stuff. Okay, so we have the extender. This extension is able for you, as you can see, extension lets you customize bug behavior using your own third-party code. So you can come here and maybe add some kind of your own extension. So but this video is going to be very, very basics for you guys. So I'm going to cover the most necessary things for you that you will be using frequently and that all hackers normally use, like the spider, the intruder, the repeater, decoder, and so on. So user option is some kind of also settings you can be able to come and set for you as a user. So you have the alerts that if you're having some kind of errors or something is going to be displaying right here. Okay, so let's go into the practical aspect of the particular course. Okay, so the first thing I would want you to do, if you come to the proxy, okay, come to the options right here. If you click on the proxy, let me click on it again so you guys will see. Click on the proxy, you see this particular option will come down, the intercept, HTTP history, WebSocket, and the option. Click on the option and make sure this is set to this 127.0.0.1, which is your local host, and the port is going to be port 8080. So if you want to edit this to maybe some other figure, you can also come and say 8081, 8088, whatever one you prefer. So if you guys have done this, I'm going to go to my browser and show you something immediately. Okay, so what I want you guys to do is to click on proxy, okay, extension for Firefox. So we have to okay, so you see we have this particular first link here, add-ons Mozilla Foxy Proxy. So I'm going to click on it. Okay, so you see I already added it. Let me remove it and add it again. So I'm going to add to Firefox. So it's going to pop up here. So I'm going to install this tool quickly, accept it, and okay. Okay, so you see now we have Foxy Proxy right here. So what I will do is I'll click on the option tab. Hope you guys are following me, and I'm going to go to add. So in this particular I'm going to use the title. I'm going to say Bob Proxy. Okay, let me say proxy like this. And this proxy IP, come on, type 127.0.0.1. Okay, so the port should be 8080. So this is what we saw in our BobSuit browser here. So because we want any request we are sending from this particular browser should be going to BobSuit, that's why we're actually setting this. So you can leave the username to be blank and the password to be blank. So I'm going to hit save right now, and as you can see we have BobSuit proxy as the name we have set, and 127.0.0.1 as the local host interface. So if you have set this, you can close the tabs, and okay, so we can go there and switch to BobSuit now. If you click on the icon right here, you see Bob proxy like you have set it. Okay, so if you have done that, what I want you guys to do now is to come here and type HTTP like this, and I want to type BobSuit. So I want to hit enter. So as you can see, hit enter and the request is still loading. That is because we are actually intercepting this particular request. So I'm going to hit forward here. Okay, so let me switch off this interceptor, because the request you actually sent from here did not actually go to this part, the website we want it to go, because we are actually capturing the request. So I'm going to cancel, hit the intercept off, and come back here and say HTTP Bob. I think it's Bob, not BobSuit. Sorry. So okay, what I want you guys to do is to come here and type in HTTP. I want you guys to come on in the URL and type in HTTP like this, and type in Bob. Okay, so I'm going to hit enter on this. Well, make sure you are capturing your request in your Foxy proxy. So that's the only way you're able to get the certificate for bobsuit, because you have to set the certificate for bobsuit. So as you can see, we have this particular page that pop up. If we are not intercepting, we won't get this page. Let me turn off my interceptor here and hit it again and click on the page. As if you can see, what's going to happen, it's not going to load up because this site won't be up. Okay, so if you come to your, make sure you are capturing your bobsuit and search on this page, as you can see, the page has actually loaded. So click on this certificate and it will automatically download for you. So I'm going to download and save it. Okay, I'm going to save it right here. As you can see, we have it saved here. All right, this particular CASAT3.dir. okay, so I will want you to come to this particular menu tab here and click on settings. So if you are using some kind of older version of Firefox, it's going to be preference. So I'm going to type in certificates. Okay, so as you can see, I searched for certificate and I have this view certificates. So I'm going to click on it and I'm going to go to import under the authorities, go to import, and I'm going to go to my download, because all my downloaded folder is going to be on my downloads. Okay, so I'm going to, as you can see, we have the latest, we the certificate we downloaded right now, which is SATSAT3.dir. So I'm going to click on it, and as you can see, certificate is already installed. Okay, because I've already installed it before. So if you have not installed it, your own is going to install for you, and I'm going to hit OK. So what this will allow us to do is, we can be able to capture all requests into bobsuit because we have provided a valid certificate to bobsuit. Okay, so I'm going to cancel it start now, and you can see, if you can see, I'm going to type in, okay, let's say google.com and hit enter. So the request is actually loading, and you see we have Google loaded here. So but if we go to our target right here, you can see what's happening on our target. If you can see, these are some things happening on our target. All the sites about Google right now is actually loading. So you see, we have Google, we have earth.google.com, duo.google.com, and like I told you before, the target tab here is to show you all the sites you are browsing on this particular site. So that's the first thing you have to do. There's nothing much here you can do. And you have some kind of tab right here where you can be able to see all the requests you are sending to google.com, because you are actually only browsing on google.com. If you come to your browser right here and browse other sites, let's say test.php.com, okay, and if you will see, if you come back to your bob proxy and look for, you see that you have that particular site we are browsing. I have to look for it. Okay, you see we have it right here, test.php.vulnerable.com. So if you have gotten all the settings correctly, that simply means you can be able to now browse your site by capturing this request, and you now are standing in between Google, your browser, and the client you are browsing. Okay, so if you can look at, you see some kind of gray and some are black. So the gray color actually means we actually browse the site from our browser, but this gray color means Google Bob actually find it out, because this site are having some kind of third-party applications running, but we have not actually browsed this on our browser. Okay, so if you go and copy this link now and browse and paste it on our browser and browse it, you're actually going to become black like this. So that is for this particular options here. Okay, so under this same target we have the sitemap, which we just finished explaining, and the scope. So this scope here is for you to set in the particular scope of what you want to be browsing on, what you're hacking on. So I'm going to hit on this use advanced scope and hit the add function. Okay, so here I'm going to type in the site I want to browse in, I want to hack on. Okay, so let me say I'll type in let's copy and paste this particular URL. Okay, vulnweb.com. So I'm going to copy it and paste it here. Okay, so this will actually tell Bob that any website that is having this particular domain is in our scope. So I want you to I want you to make this in scope item. Okay, so I'm going to hit OK right now, and you see it's giving us some kind of warning or some kind of option here. We're going to say yes. And now if we go back to our sitemap and click on this filter hiding this particular page you are seeing here and go to show only in scope option, and I'm going to hit at the blank page here, and you can see everything now is now going out, and we have only the site we put on scope here. So you see we have this one web.com, and we use the advanced option which is the rejects, and you see now we have only test.php dot vulnerable.com. So whatever domain we are browsing on our website web browser, which is our Firefox, that is having this particular vulnerable.com here, is going to be showing here. Whatever website you are browsing that is not having this particular vulnerable.com won't be showing on our browser. So that is it for this target. Hope you guys understand the basics of it. So coming to the proxy, like I showed you guys, if I should click on any page on this particular interceptor, this intercept, so if I should browse, keep browsing these sites now, everything will be browsing for me and it will be sending requests to Bob Suit. So let's say for example I want to hit on this browse artist, okay, but I'm going to turn on this particular intercept now. So by going back to the my browser and click on browse artist, it's going to be loading right here. As you guys can see, it's loading. What happened is this: the request has been captured by Bob Suit under this intercept because we actually turned it on. So this will, we can come here and start adjusting some kind of things to edit this particular page, and click, if we click on forward, the page is actually going to load. But right now you see that the page is not loading, see, because we intercept, we are in the middle of it and we are holding this request from going to this particular website. So I'm going to come right down here now and hit forward. As you can see, hit forward, let me turn it off and see what happened. The page has actually loaded. It's no more loading. It has actually come to the artist.php. Okay, so that is for this particular intercept, is for you to intercept requests from you as this client to the server. Okay, so we have the HTTP history. HTTP history will actually come and tell us all the history of what we have browsed. So what I'm going to show, since we have our in scope item, we are going to come here and say show only in scope item, and it's going to put only the in scope item that we have set. So you see we have click on all these buttons on our website, and you see that all these buttons we have clicked on now are shown in the history of our HTTP request. So that is for this, and this WebSocket is just kind of showing us the kind of socket. If you browse some site uses sockets, so if you are browsing web some on the side are using some kind of socket, web sockets, you are going to be seeing the request here, and we have some option. So this option we see, I already told you guys how to set up this particular proxy listener and some other things, and this is the certificate we actually imported to our Firefox. So you can come here and regenerate, but I would advise not to do that. Use the method I show you guys by browsing HTTP BOP. So other settings here are not that relevant, but as you are learning and you are hacking your way in, maybe you might come here and start saying, okay, we have some intercept client requests. You can come here and say, want to intercept the request that is in our scope. Some settings you can be able to read through and understand. So you see, we can intercept response. As you come into this interceptor here, before you send the request, you can say, okay, want to intercept the response of the request. Okay, so some kind of settings can come here and read all through. So you have some response modification, you can come here and say remove JavaScript and so on. Most of them are not that relevant, but if you are hacking your way and you stay in this particular field of web application penetration tests, you are going to understand this as time goes on and as you keep getting familiar with Bob Suit. So another particular tool I want to show you guys is the spider. So as you can see, we have actually requested 35 queued. So what you can actually, spider request, like I told you guys, is a kind of tool that help us click on each buttons of the sites we are browsing in with automatically. Okay, so I'm going to go to the target and I'm going to click on this particular website. Okay, and as you can see, we have spider this host. So if I click on it, so you see the spider has been highlighted showing some kind of red light red, and you can see that we are actually spidering the host right now. And what you are seeing is some kind of form are supposed to be submitted. can come here and say submit form, or you can reject submission of the form. So as you can see, it keep coming up. What this is doing is it's clicking on this particular site for us. You see, it's going to be clicking on this particular buttons here. Click on, and see, we have some sign up form here that it actually come here and try to, if you click in the submit form, to come here and put a dummy username and password field for you. So this is what Spider actually does in Bob Suits. Okay, so I'm going to come to my Spider right here to see all the requests is sent in. So you see now we are having 489 and 840 transferred, and we have requests made. Okay, so you can come here and say, okay, you want to clear the queues to start making new Spider requests, and you can come here and say you want to pause it. So if you are hacking your way in and you don't want to click on the every page of the site by yourself, can come here and say you want to spider it. So this will actually start spidering the site. So as you can see, we have some kind of request going on into the artist, and you see it's actually taking the parameter 3. So you can come here and say, okay, how, what hackers will think in this is to say, okay, I want to change this to 4 to see whatever is going to display to me. So hope you guys understand the spider function. So this particular scanner, like I told you guys, is for people who have already purchased Bob Suits Community Edition. I mean Professional Edition, I'm sorry about that. So you can come here and start saying you want to perform some kind of active scan. As you can see, we have active scan right here on our target. So if you have Professional Edition, you can use this active scan to start looking for web application vulnerabilities automatically for you. It's because Bob Suits is one of the most best tool for penetration testers. Okay, so we have the intruder right here. This intruder right here is a tool that is used to actually brute force usernames, password, directories, API, and so on, endpoints. So what we can, how we can actually use this is, let's come to our proxy, okay, our HTTP history, and say, okay, we have this login form. Okay, let's, I think we have some kind of login form. I'm coming, I'm going to show you guys this really quick. So let's just take something like this, and we are going to say send it to intruder. All right, so as you can see, we have it on the intruder right here, which is this is the website, and this is the port we are actually browsing. So we can come to the position now and say clear this particular position. So now what position we want to force, let's say we want to force on this particular 3. Okay, so we are going to highlight it and come here and add it. Okay, we're going to hit the on this add button here, and you see we have it queued. Okay, and so if you come to the payload, and we are going to come here and say payload set 1, which is 1, and payload type, we can come here and say numbers. Sorry about that. Okay, we are coming and say numbers. Okay, sequential from 1 to, let's say, 15. I'm just giving, and we are going to say in the, with a step of 1. Do you know why we are doing that? So if, for example, you are browsing on this site and you see we have the peak, which is 3, I want to browse, I want to change this to from 1 to 15 to see maybe there's some kind of pictures that we are not supposed to see. That is actual, so that we are supposed to see. But as an hacker right now, I'm going to say, okay, we want to start browsing, we want to start changing this figure of that is 3 to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on, to know if maybe there's some kind of picture that is supposed to be private or not. So we are going to start saying, okay, want any place, this particular place that is highlighted right here, particularly I highlighted here, we want to start changing the figure from 1 to 15 that we actually set here. Okay, so we can come here and say start this attack. Okay, so it's going to prompt up that we are using Bob Suits Community Edition. It is going to be very slow, but if you purchase the Professional Edition, it's going to go very fast. Okay, so let's hit enter right here. So you see it actually started and say, okay, we put 1 on that particular parameter we highlighted and added, and you see we have some kind of 200 code response, and we put 2 here. As you can see it here, we put 2, and you see we actually got success also. We put 3, and that's how we are going to start changing each figure we set here on our payload. And you can see we have God, we have finished this particular request and we can okay come and say, okay, what are we actually doing? We are trying to force on this peak parameter. Okay, so if you are actually browsing a site that is having username and password on this particular field, you can come here and say in the username field and provide some kind of username list on this particular payload here. You can come here and say, okay, simple list, and you come here and paste the username list you're having, and you can, by when you choose, actually choose it. Okay, let's make it a quick practical of this so that you understand what I'm saying. Okay, so let's say we have username test, okay, and password test, and I'm going to hit enter on this. Okay, so we are, if we come down to this our proxy, the HTTP history, you see we have some kind of user info which we have with the test and the tests. So we actually capture this request right here. So I'm going to send it to intruder right now. So by sending to intruder, we see that in intruder tab we have the position which we are going to clear it first and say, okay, we want this test parameter here to be added to what we are going to be forcing, and this particular password parameter we want it also to force. So now we are going to come into the payload now and say, okay, let's come and say we want to try and admin as the list. If you can come here and add and paste several list of usernames and password. Okay, so I'm going to say admin, let's say John. So this is a some kind of way you can, let's just keep putting random figures. As you can see, let's put in random figure so maybe you understand. So this is kind of list of username we have to add, and let's come to the second parameter. Before we do that, we have to come to the position here and say, okay, we want this to be, let's say, cluster bomb, so that, because we want to start forcing for the username and the password field together. So we can come here and say payload 2, and come here and start adding some the payload we want to use, let's say password 2. Okay, so we can hit enter, let's say password, sorry. So this is kind of example I'm trying to do. Let's say test, okay, let's say test 2, let's say test 1 2 3. Okay, so you see now have all this here, so we can come here and add up the username field, let's say test also, and we have the payload. So what I would advise you to do is to go out there, look for username list and password list once you are trying to force, to hack, to use a brute force attack against a login form. This is what you're actually doing. So if we hit in start attack, so it's going to prompt us with the warning, and we're going to hit okay. So you see it's going to start sending the admin and the password you actually set for it, the John and the password you actually set for it. So if you come here, you see the username is John and the password is pass2 we actually set. So it's going to come here, go through the list that we provide to it by trying to guess out the correct username and the password for this particular attack. Okay, so once this came out, once we have got the right username and the right password for it, is going to come out, and by using some kind of status code here, maybe we might find out, okay, we got the answer, the correct username and password. Or if by using the length here, you can be able to know, okay, this length is 621, and this, you see, we have some kind of length differences right here. So by using the status code, we know that all other requests that are not correct, you're having 302, which is redirect. Okay, now we come and see that we have test for the payload 1 and test for the payload 2, which is the payload 1 is the username field and the payload 2 is the password field. So, and we have 200. Okay, that means this request is actually different from these other ones that we are having 302. So we can come here and go to the browser now and say, okay, we actually find out that test and tests is some kind, have some kind of difference in status code and in the length. You see we have some kind of difference. So let's hit the, let's come and see if it's actually the correct password, as Bob Suit actually gave us some kind of hint on that. And you can see we log into the site. Okay, so these are common ways hackers use Bob Suit to actually brute force your username and password. So Hope you guys understand the intruder tab, and we are going to go to the repeater tab right now. Okay, so let's go to the tag targets. So now if you hit on this particular request and right click, you can see we have the send to repeater. So I'm going to send to repeater right now, and I'm going to go to my repeater tab. This repeater tab actually give you this request here. So it wants, if you are modifying it, you can also have the request and be able to see the response at the same time. So let's say we are changing this 3 here to 1, and we can actually hit on go. So the thing actually went to this server we are actually browsing on, and you see it gave us the request we actually are browsing right now. Okay, so if you come to the render, you see that we can actually render the page, and this is the page of that we are rendering. So if you come to the this particular parameter right here, we are having 1, and say okay, let's change it to 2 and let's see what will happen. Look at the image you are seeing right here. Now you can hit on you can click on it and see if there's some kind of changes there. As you can see, we actually have some change in the image. So that actually means that this particular parameters right here is actually changing the request we are actually sending to the site. So it's, as the name actually seems, is actually some kind of tool that is used to repeat a particular request you are sending to your server. Okay, so these are the kind of way hackers normally think. Okay, since we are having some kind of parameters, let me start removing these, let me start putting this to know on this particular request you are sending to the browser, because you're browsing the site to normal browser, you won't be able to see all these particular request that is going. You're actually going to be start clicking on each buttons, and only that's all you are seeing. Well, Bobsuit actually help you capture the request and see the raw request that's actually going to the clients you are browsing on. Okay, so hope you guys understand the repeater tab. There is nothing special than what we have actually showed you guys. So if you're browsing on this site, you might come and say okay, let me remove this repeat this referral and click okay to know if there's any change in the part in this particular request. Okay, the host header, this which is this host. Okay, if I come here and say okay, let me delete the host and put in, let's say, google.com, is there something special about this? Okay, so we are going to hit enter and see what will actually happen. So you see the request actually cannot go through, because maybe the site is using some kind of host header to know where we are actually browsing. So that is it for the repeater tab. As you can see, the sequencer is we are not going to be spending much time here. What you guys have to actually know is this particular repeater, intruder, your proxy, and targets. Okay, but like I said, this sequencer is some kind of live target capturing. If you are, let me say, you are browsing on a site that is actually making calls or requests to maybe your particular phone number, 2-factor authenticator, you can come here and say okay, I want to be seeing the live capturing that you are actually doing. So maybe if you come here and say send this particular request to sequencer. Okay, so if you come to the sequencer, you'll be able to start seeing what is actually happening. So on this decoder right here, we are going to spend a little time in it. Okay, so you see we have this particular request here, which is having this one as a parameters. Most time some website uses some kind of encoding format in this. We say if you to see one, you will see some kind of random numbers, which is most time maybe binary, sometime what is it called, some kind of encodings. Okay, so you can come here and say okay, maybe the one is being encoded, you can come here and say want to encode this to base64. Encode to base64. So as you can see, this is the encoded format for base64. So if you come here and copy this and come back and say okay, we want to paste this base64 format as 1 for us. So let's see what is going to happen. As you can see, we are actually not having any good request. You are having an error. Okay, so if for example this particular site is having this particular parameter here as base64, we can copy it and come and say okay, in the decoder tab, let's paste it there and say we want to decode it as base64. So as you can see, as we decode our base64, we actually have 1. So we can come here, copy it now and say okay, go into the repeater tab and say this particular request now wants to put it as one, since we can decode the format it was. So we are, if we enter now, you see that we actually got the page. So that is it for the decoder. So this comparer right here, like I said, is for you to come and say, okay, I want to, you can copy this particular request and say, okay, send to comparer. So you can while you copy other requests and say, I want to, so you can start coming here and say, let me compare this and compare that to know what is the difference between these two particular pages and this the API, the some kind of tokens and so on. So there's nothing much there. So this extender is for you now to be able to, let's say you want to add up your own format of the, you want to add up your own code. Most people can be able, you can be able to write your own code to WorkSuite by, let's say you write your own kind of tool you want to add to WorkSuite, which I will be showing you guys in a later video, that you are going to be able to add some kind of tool using this extender. You can come here and add the format of the tool. If it's written in Python, Ruby or Java and so on, you can come here and add them up. So it's nothing much for a daily hacking. It's only if you actually got your own tool, you can be able to use that particular this thing. So project option, you can come here and read through. There's nothing much here. To me, there's nothing much here for now. As a beginner level, that you guys are, there's nothing much for you to actually learn from here. So you see the platform authentication, those settings are configured within user option, but you can override here for this specific project. Okay, so some kind of upstream proxy and so on, you hardly will not touch this for a very long time. And so coming to the user option, you see those settings lets you configure BOP to automatically carry out the authentication destination to web server. So you can come here and say you want to start checking on what this actually do. Well, it's nothing much too. Okay, so as we are actually browsing this site, you see we have the proxy and some kind of error that it prompt us. So this is for you, if you're having some kind of error, you can go back and say maybe you need to come to your target to know if your target is actually going through, and if you are having a good connection to your browser. So I think that's all we are going to touch for now in Bob Suits. If you quick recap, a target is where you get all the target website you are browsing. You can come here and add to scope or to move from scope. You can also come to your proxy to see how you can be able to intercept the immediate request you are sending to your web browser. Coming to the history of all the pages you have clicked on a web browser, the web socket, if the site you are using is using a socket, and some kind of option for you to come and set the local host you want to intercept on, and some other options right here. So the spider is actually for you to be able to let WorkSuite automatically click on every buttons for you. We are having the scanner, which is for WorkSuite professional, that can help you to start looking for vulnerability like cross-site scripting, SQL injections, cross-site request forgery, which is CSRF, and some kind of vulnerability like that. You have the intruder, which is used to brute force both username, passwords, API, and so on. The repeater for you to repeat the current request you're having here, so that because it won't be likely for you to go to your browser and start clicking on every page, sending it one after the other. So by having your request here, you can actually start adjusting some kind of parameters here and other things to start repeating them. As the name I've said, sequencer, some kind of live capturing, as you can see right here. And we have the decoder, which you can use to decode and encode some kind of some strings and some format to know what's actually happening. So I think that's where I'm going to end the stream. Hope I try my best explaining this to the level I can. So hope you guys enjoyed this particular video, and in the next video we are going to be talking on how we can start looking for vulnerabilities using WorkSuite.